In this Adobe Premiere tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can quickly make a countdown timer. This is a countdown timer that will start at some amount of minutes and seconds and then count down to zero. You can make these countdown timers in Adobe Premiere any length that you want, and it's quite simple. The first thing you want to do is have a sequence. Here I have a sequence in Premiere called Countdown, and it is on my timeline. Then you can create a new item. So you can either right-click in your project bin, and then click New Item, Transparent Video. Then we want to pick our time base. Here you can see the frame rate of my sequence, and so I'm going to pick 60 frames per second. You may have a different frame rate, so pick the appropriate frame rate for your video. And then I'll click OK. Now I have this transparent video. I can drag this transparent video into my timeline. Next, I need to move the playhead. The playhead in Adobe Premiere is this blue item, to where I need it to be for the end of my timer. Let's say I want a 30-second timer. So then I can just type in 30 and then press return. Now the playhead is right at 30 seconds. I can then drag this clip and it'll snap right there. If you don't have snapping turned on, make sure you click this magnet icon. Now I have a 30-second transparent video. Next, go to the effects panel. In the search bar of the Adobe Premiere effects panel, type timecode. This is what we need to make our countdown timer in Adobe Premiere. I'll drag timecode onto the transparent video. Then I can click the transparent video and go to effects controls. It's up at the top left here. If I move my playhead, you'll notice that yes, I do have timecode, but it's kind of ugly and it has these extra markings. The first thing to do is go ahead and change how it displays. So you see this field symbol? If I undo this check mark, then the field symbol goes away. And then the timecode source should not be the media, because that'll be actually the media of what you're using. And sometimes this is good, but we want to generate. So now we're generating our timecode. So this way it will start at zero and then end at our 30 seconds. But we don't want to see all those extra zeros. So once again, in the effects panel, go to search and type crop. You can then drag the crop onto your transparent video. Scroll down in the effects panel, and on the left, move over the crop to approximately 46 on the left, and then 46 on the right. Now, if you change the size of this video text, this number on your crop will be different. Now we have our countdown timer that counts up. How do we make the countdown timer actually count down from a number to zero? It's as simple as right-clicking on your transparent video and then nesting it. We can call this anything we want and then press OK. Then right-click on your nested sequence and go to speed duration. You can either click reverse speed or you can type negative 100%. They're both the same thing. Now you can see that my time starts at 29 and then goes down to zero. If you need an offset, I can go into this timeline right here and I can make sure that I have an offset. So if you see right on the end here, my video goes to 30 seconds, but I need one more second. So if I go ahead and drag to 31, and then I move my transparent video just a bit longer, then I can go to my countdown, and now it starts at 30. So you can make it so it starts at the seconds that you need. Sometimes that can trip you up. Next, how do we put this on top of a video? I'll move my nested sequence right up to the top here, and then I'll go to my project panel, and I'll bring in this train clip. You can see that when this goes on top of the train clip, we give a little bit of a black border. We don't want that, so what we can do is change the blend mode to screen, and that'll take that black border away. And then, of course, we can scale this up however we want, and then change the position. And then this will count down just as your train or whatever it is that you're working on goes by. Hopefully this will allow you to make quick countdown timers in Adobe Premiere Pro. Happy video editing.